Hi, my name is Charity Nicolas. I am a principal environmental health and safety consultant with a global environmental company called Environmental Resources Management. I'm also a community leader, an entrepreneur, the founder of Tech in Color. I originally wanted to be a doctor, but you know, something happened to me when I was in college. My best friend and roommate was killed on campus, and it made me really think about my purpose in life. I know for me, it was a very traumatic experience and made me realize, you know, there must be a way that this could have been prevented. So after I graduated from college, I actually got my master's degree in environmental health and safety. I realized I had a lot to learn just to have credibility in the industry. You know, who was I, first generation Pinay? I had a lot of imposter syndrome. I worked for the Centers for Disease Control, and I was very lucky because I got to work with a group that traveled around the country. It became a very eye-opening experience by opening myself up to, you know, exploring and seeing what that means and getting my credentials and, you know, learning the business. I came back into the Bay Area working as a consultant. I got a lot of like simple jobs, but you know, you gotta start somewhere. Because I was able to start with a lot of those simple jobs, it meant that I was a better trainer, but you have to advocate for yourself. So if I didn't advocate for myself, I would still be doing that. As I was coming up in the industry, one thing that I saw is very subtle discrimination. I remember I was working for this large government organization. It was all men. And every month I would go to their meetings, right? And I'd share about safety. I'd tell them about a safety topic. And every time I went to those meetings, they would challenge me, checking if I knew what I was talking about. They'd ask me questions and they would purposely try to trip me up. And by the end of working with them, it's like everything I told them and advised them, they started doing. And I think that's what we have to realize. You know, sometimes people don't know where we're coming from, and we really have to, you know, take the time to build those relationships. I didn't really realize how much impact I had as a Filipino leader in my profession. You know, I just saw myself as a professional. I didn't see myself as a Filipina in my profession. When I was working for this government agency in 2010, there was this incident that happened. There was a Pinay that was killed. When I saw that happen, it struck me and it reminded me of that experience I had when my roommate was killed. And it helped me see that I could make an impact by using my voice. I started using my voice to really help outside of my profession and helping my community in other ways. I volunteered to be the president of the Filipino American Alumni Chapter here at Cal. Through that experience, it taught me about working as an executive in a nonprofit board. One of the things that I felt was most impactful was bringing our community together to raise funds for the Grace Ruelo Ascension Scholarship in honor of my late roommate. We were able to tell her story again, also using that to help them realize the power that they had to change the world. Even after Grace passed away, there are measures in place to keep people safe. From the alumni chapter, it also opened me up to understanding where else are alums making an impact. Places like Pinayista, focusing on women of color, starting businesses, becoming entrepreneurs. And with FASTER, working with Filipino Americans in science, tech, engineering, and math. You know, these are things that will help our Filipino community. Be open. Be open to learning. Don't be afraid of the power within you. For a long time, I was afraid, and I didn't even realize that I had the power to change my community, to change the world. And once I realized that, I think I was really able to make an impact. So don't be afraid.